Hi everyone, welcome to my little corner where there's no wrong way to play with paper. I hope you're having a good day. I really do. Welcome to another Scraps to Embellishment video. If it's your first time, I'm so glad that you're here. I would love it if you subscribed and hang out with me, and you never know what's going to happen around this joint. Oh no, Scraps to Embellishment is a series that I do with my swaps over on Ginger's Corner Facebook group. So I'd love if you would join us and participate if you want to swap with other crafty folks like us. And then also I have friends who are doing Scraps to Embellishments Hop 2024, where we take our scraps and we create beautiful things. Now everybody does a different thing with their scraps, and not everyone is able to post every week, but when they find a theme that they like and they have time, they share their talent with us. So there is a one click spot. Go in the description, you can click one link and you will see everyone's. There's a playlist and it's a lot of fun. But if you want to check out individuals, which I invite you to do that, they are amazing crafters. If you scroll a little bit further in the description, you'll see each individual link. So that's a lots of fun, and I know you'll be inspired. Maybe my embellishment today doesn't inspire you, but somebody else's will, and that's what this whole community is about for me. Let's just have fun. So each month, the members over on Ginger's Corner Facebook vote on what the theme will be for the monthly swap. Now, you guys have heard me talk about mini swaps all the time. This is a monthly swap where instead of four, we create 10, and the members of Ginger's Corner vote usually on the 15th of the month before. So like this is April, they voted in March. So, and the winning theme this month was April showers. So anything to do with rain was allowed. And I came up with this cute little bunny. Look how cute he is. I'll put close-ups at the end. And I used my scraps. That's why if you look over here, there's lots of different color bunnies. There's some with some pattern paper. There's some that aren't. Lots and lots of fun. So I'm going to show you. I did get this as a Temu die. It's no longer available. Oh, this is why I do my Temu hauls and share them, because most of the time, by the time I use the die set to share with you, it's no longer available. But I bet you saw this, because this was all over Temu. And it was a lot, really easy die, but I did have to kind of jazz it up, for lack of a better way. And I like to make one and hang out with y'all. I hope you enjoy that part of the video. And it's time to do that. So again, all different color embellishments, right? Because I used whatever scraps I had to create with. And different, I cut out the bunnies. Now, to jazz these up, I used markers, right? And I inked with my ink pads and my daubers. So I already inked the little bunnies, and I used my markers to highlight, because it is embossed when you do it. Here, maybe the white one is better to show. So you can see it does have little embossing marks, and that's where you know to put your marker highlights. That's the best word for it, highlights. Then I wanted to make the umbrella stand out a little bit. So I've already highlighted the embossed areas and the edges. And then I just took a Sharpie. Y'all, sometimes our best tools are just everyday things, right? So I just took a Sharpie, and I'm just going to do the handle of the umbrella in a black. Just like that. Okay. I did take little gems. I have these 3mm flat back gems that I absolutely love for like eyes and details and center of flowers. They are my favorite. I bought these once. I did these solid colors, and then I have a multicolored one. They're like variated like this here. And I think they were like $8 on Amazon, and I still have, it's been 2 years since I bought them. I still have a bunch. So, and I always, everything that I share on Amazon, I do have a link. It is an affiliate link, but you can just look up 3mm flat back gems and you'll find all kinds of stuff. You don't have to use mine. I just do that so when somebody asks me, I have one link to share with everyone. I can just copy and paste it. It's totally a lazy thing. Okay, so next I needed to glue. I don't know what I want. I need to glue. Let me take out my bling. And I need to glue my little bunnies on. Whoops, that was a lot. Oh my goodness, we don't need that much. Let's see if we can't share. Sharing's caring. I'm sharing the glue. And I want his arm to come over the edge. And I'm just kind of mimicking what's already in my example photo. Because you guys know I like to print off little examples from my Temu hauls so that I know what it's supposed to look like. It helps me sometimes figure out what dye piece goes where, to be truthful. Okay, so you notice I didn't say to be honest. I'm getting better. Then I took a little hole punch. It does come, let me move my bling again. I should show you guys some of my bling. I'll do that here in a minute. I ordered new bling from Debbie. So it does come with a little flower dye for the her hair right here, right? I'm lazy and easier is my thing. So I just took a scrap. This is why I save all these little scraps in my little egg carton and my milk crate. And this will just go right back in my milk crate on my cart. Now, if you've watched any of my organizing videos, you know I love these milk crates. I keep all kinds of stuff in them. This one happens to be teal. Most of mine are black. And I will just put these in there. And see, if you look, these were already... A lot of times I'll cut my scraps down to 6x6 so I can use them for my scraps embellishments so they're not piling up, right? These are all the leftovers from the umbrella, and yeah, I use some of them for the flowers and they still end up in here because I can still punch things out of them. So just a little tip, you know, when this is full for me, I have to do something with it. It doesn't happen often because I do use my scraps for sure. Oh gosh, it's just like wanting to come out of there. I'm still not used to the art glitter glue. I'm trying to be, but I'm still not. That's a little bit too much glue. That's all right. Okay, so then I'm going to take one of my flatback gems. Not even going to squeeze it. Look how much glue is coming out of there. All right, y'all, help me out. What am I doing wrong over here? There we go. And just like that, it's all done. Now, you could stamp a sentiment across here or whatever you would like to do. I'm going to wipe this off a little bit before I put my bling back on. And jazz it up however you want. Like, you could do a lot of other things. Maybe you could put a scallop background. I thought about all of those. But you know what? I'm going to let everyone put their own sentiment on this time. Because I made 40. I didn't want to do it. I'm not going to lie. But if I was doing it for me, and remember, when you get your embellishment, it's yours. Jazz it up even more. I do it all the time. You guys see me do it in my layout process videos. Just that's how you make your clusters, is by layering things on top of an already made embellishment. It goes so fast too. All right, so let me show you some of my bling. I know I got distracted here. So looky here. I got a flamingo for summer from Miss Deb. Now she offers all of Gender Corner members, she offers us a 10% off discount. So make sure you use Gender's Corner. That is the discount, and you'll find the link and everything in the description. You guys, I had to get a little Geico. Can you see that? Let me see here. Look, it's a little Geico. I live in the desert. My kids and I see these little lizards all over the time. I mean, how stinking cute are those? So there's that one. Because I am in Texas, I also got little cowboy gems. And for the 4th of July, I got this one. Yeah, I went a little crazy, but that's okay. I love Miss Deb. And she is Bree Creative Crafts on Scentsy. And the link is below, along with the coupon code. Go tell her I said hi. Say Ginger sent me. Tell her I said hi. It was very, very sweet of her. She donated for a giveaway earlier this year. She also gave us the coupon code for Evers and Evers. So, Deb, thank you so much. I love, love your work. I think I'm going to go with my little Geico. Oh, look, that rhymes. And I'm going to switch out my bling. She always sends you a cleaner pen. And she does have these to fit the Scotch quick dry as well. So I'm just going to stick it right on in there. And look, now I have a little Geico and we're going to put up the glue. I will put my owl for another day. I'm going to have to come up with a little container because to me, the owl is for fall. I know. I need to get out, but it's so fun. Like, you know, these are things I touch every day. I'm in my scrap room every day. So I like to make it fun. Decorate my house and my glue bottle. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to stop talking now. You guys, I hope you have lots of fun crafting. I hope you are blessed. And I will see you next time. Bye.